Hello friends, today we are going to talk about a rag that has been derived from Carnatic music into Hindustani music and a very popularly used rag in the lighter genres of Hindustani music including Thumri, Ghazal, Bhajan and of course Bollywood music. And a rag that has also been used in compositions, in the lighter compositions in other languages besides Hindi. But of course, we are going to talk about Bollywood mainly. The name of the rag is Charukeshi. Charukeshi, a very melodic structure. It is considered to be a Sampurna rag, meaning it has all the swars and the sixth and the seventh swars, that is, Dha and Ni are komal, which means they are flat. And some people say that it belongs to Bhairav Thaat. Bhairav Thaat, Thaat of course means the source from where every rag is born. So the rags which are born from Bhairav Thaat, they are sung normally in the morning time. So some people say Charukeshi is sung in the morning. Some people say that Charukeshi is sung in the latter half of the evening, that is after 8 p.m. or 9 p.m. But the fact remains that it is a very melodic cycle, melodic structure, I mean. The notes of Charukeshi sound something like this. Sa re ga ma pa dha. See, you see the dha going a little flat, like komal. Pa dha ni sa, sa ni dha pa ma ga ma re sa. So this is the scale of Charukeshi. Now, before we move on to the connection of Charukeshi with Bollywood music, let's first see how it sounds when it is sung in a classical music style. This is something that I would really want to highlight in my future posts also. So if we take a rag which is common to both classical and light music, the way it is sung in classical music and the way the same swars are incorporated into light music, it will be very interesting to note the difference. It's a very subtle difference, but let's see how it sounds in a classical music setup. So you, and I must also specify here that the difference is seen mainly when we do an alap in a rag. When we just sing a composition, be it classical or any other light song, we may not be able to figure out the difference that much. And when we sing an alap, that is when the rag sounds different. Now there are some light music songs in which we have alap. So alap obviously means when you sing the swars very slowly. So in light music songs, sometimes we hear that in between words, there are certain sections which are sung either with swars or just with the sound A, and they are sung slower, and that is what is alap. Now that alap is different from the way the same rag will be sung in classical music. So let's see how Charukeshi sounds in classical music style. Sa dha 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 dha. Hey. Sound in a classical music setup. As you can see, it's a very gradual, slow singing of the swars. And also before singing a new section of swars, you notice that I give a little bit of a weight on the first note, like the hey. So it's not just it's not a light weight. It's a nice heavy weight on the notes that we give when we sing classical music. I should say lighter stress rather than weight, I think. Yeah. So now the same alap, suppose if there is a light music song in Charukeshi and you want to start with an alap, how will that happen? How it sounds in a light music setup. So as you can see, the slow gradual build-up that we heard in classical music does not happen in light music. It's a cluster of swars that you sing and at a much faster pace. And that's why obviously the stress is also lighter and not a heavy stress as we heard in classical music style. So now coming to how this classical rag is connected to light music and more with respect to Bollywood music. Now, the amazing part of our classical music is that the same notes can convey totally different moods. So Charukeshi, although it has two komal swars, flat notes, dha and ni, sometimes you may say that it is more suitable for devotional singing or songs with a little bit of pathos in them. But you will see now that Charukeshi can also be sung during happy occasions, or it can be sung like a romantic song. But this first song that I'm going to sing for you, and of course I'll be just singing two lines, not more than that, just so you get a feel as to how it is connected to our Bollywood music. The first song is one of my very favorites, which is sung by Rafi Sahab. And it basically depicts the mood of longing, meaning somebody really longing for somebody to come to them. अकेले हैं चले आओ जहाँ हो, अकेले हैं चले आओ जहाँ हो, कहाँ आवाज दे तुमको, कहाँ हो अकेले हैं चले आओ जहां हूं। So you can see the longing, right, that is there in this in these notes, and very aptly represented by the words, and how the words and the swaras are going so hand in hand to express the feeling of longing and loneliness. So this is one, but on the other hand, you have a very happy song in which two people come together, and even that can be shown in Charukeshi with this duet sung by Lata Ji and Rafi Sahab. Bekhudi mein sanam lut uth gaye do kadam, bekhudi mein sanam uth gaye jo kadam, आ गए पास हम, आ गए पास हम, बेखुदी में सनम उठ गए जो कदम। सी नाउ यू कैन मेक आउट द सेम नोट्स दैट आई सैंग फॉर अकेले हैं, आई यूज द सेम नोट्स फॉर दिस सॉन्ग ऑल्सो, बट इट्स कन्वेइंग अ टोटली डिफरेंट मूड, इट्स कन्वेइंग अ हैप्पी मूड व्हेन पीपल टू पीपल हैव कम टुगेदर. Now there is a very beautiful ghazal of Mehndi Hasan Sahab, a very very romantic and a very melodiously composed ghazal, which goes something like this. Jab us zulf ki baat chali, jab us zulf ki बात चली, ढलते ढलते रात ढली, ढलते ढलते रात ढली, जब उस जुल्फ की बात चली, ढलते ढलते रात ढली, ढलते ढलते रात ढली, जब उस जुल्फ की बात चली. सो दिस इज द फील ऑफ अ गजल. इट ऑलमोस्ट गिव्स लाइक अ सेंसुअस फीलिंग, इजंट इट? ढलते ढलते रात ढली, एंड द वे द नोट्स गो सो वेल विद द वर्ड्स इन दिस गजल. नाउ द नेक्स्ट type of song that Charukeshi also can be presented so well in is the devotional composition. Go something like this. Hari naam ki mala japo, japte raho, हरि भक्ति मार्ग पे भावस, हरि भक्ति मार्ग पे भावस, चलते रहो चलते रहो, हरि नाम की जपते रहो जपते रहो. सो दिस वॉज अ डिवोशनल एस्पेक्ट, एंड फाइनली अ मूड ऑफ लाइक एन अश्योरेंस और अ प्रॉमिस, मीनिंग we will always be together on any path, and we will never leave each other. So to convey that kind of a feeling, a very popular duet by Lata Ji and Mukesh Ji this time. Kisi raah mein kisi mood par,
कहीं चल न देना तू छोड़ कर मेरे हम सफर, मेरे हम सफर, मेरे हम सफर, मेरे हम सफर।
So you can see how beautifully the tune has been woven, and it so well represents the words. And mind you, the notes are the same for all these three or four different compositions that I sang. But still, it's the greatness of the composers who have woven the same notes into different moods and express those moods so effectively, all those varying moods. And of course, the singers also who have brought out these moods so effectively in their singing. So this is how Charukeshi goes. So, and of course, it's an endless thing, isn't it? There are so many songs that we could go on and on. But these are just some trailers of songs of different genres, and just to show as to how the same notes, same set of notes can be represented in different moods of songs. And this is the beauty of our music. So I hope to continue this series. Let's hope that I can find some different rags. Of course, we have many common rags about which so many people have talked about, which are very popularly used in Bollywood music. I will definitely touch upon those rags also, because they are, you know, evergreen, as we call it. You know, as many times as you hear them, they feel new. But my efforts also would be to present some rags which are not commonly talked about. And so in this attempt, Charukeshi was the first rag. I hope to see you with a new rag in my next week's posting. In the meanwhile, please do share your feedback and your comments. Thank you so much, and happy listening.